In this episode, you'll learn about microphones, and we'll run through what microphones there are, how they work, and what all those switches do. The world of microphones. It's like looking into a field of grass and deciding which blade is best one for you. Let's pare right back to the very basics so we can see the wood from the trees. What is a microphone? Well, a microphone is a piece of equipment that registers sound and converts it to a tiny electrical signal that's boosted up and recorded onto some format for reproduction later. There are lots of types of microphone. There are two main groups, dynamic and condenser. Dynamic mics work under their own power. Condenser mics need either a battery, power supply, or phantom power to work. The condenser mics are much more sensitive and can be found in all sorts of professional areas such as recording studios and location recording setups. Within our two groups of mics, there are lots of types of mics for every type of application you could imagine. There's vocal mics, rifle mics, lav mics, hydrophones, stethoscopes, ribbon, USB, multi-pattern, stereo, binaural, bass, ambisonic, surround, to name just a few. Let's look at the common attributes of microphones. Firstly, the top contains the capsule or capsules. So this is where all the work is done. A little diaphragm wobbles when the sound passes over it, and the diaphragm is connected to a wire that moves through a metal coil, thus generating an electrical signal. So that's the physics bit. I love physics. Generally, the lead that plugs into a microphone is a female XLR, or Canon, as it was known in the olden days. Though some other mics have their own power supply, and they may have a different connection going to the microphone, and the female XLR connects into the power supply. The other end of your mic lead, the male XLR, will connect to your amp or your interface or some other such equipment. What we see on some microphones are an on-off switch. On some, you see a high-pass filter that cuts out all the lower frequencies just to keep the signal cleaner. Some also have a pad, which cuts the signal by 10 or 20 dB if the noise you're recording is too loud for the equipment that you're recording onto. Another very important thing that you may see on microphones are little signs like these, polar patterns. Polar patterns are the diagram that explains what area around the mic capsule or capsules will pick up the sound from. We did a show on polar patterns and is available from the main Perfecting Audio playlist. I'll put the link in below. A while ago, we did a show on audio interfaces and how to get them working with your computer. Now that we know how a mic operates, then next time let's look at how to effectively use them and help you decide what is the best one for your current and future needs. I'm Keith Alexander and you've been watching Adorama TV. Don't forget to subscribe to Adorama TV for more great videos and tell us what you think. You can like, you can comment, or you can share this video. And please come by the Adorama Learning Center for more great tips and tricks.